racism doesn't exist anymore.
And what about anti-white racism?
Our country is one of the most tolerant places in the world. I'm not a racist.
Systemic racism. Does that mean that everyone is racist?
We often hear the expression systemic racism, and it's sometimes difficult to understand what it means. Well, let's talk about it. When we think of racism, what do we think about? We almost immediately think of insults or prejudices, but that's only the tip of the iceberg. Under the surface hides a system that is much more complex. Racism is a system that has created and maintains inequalities between white people and racialized people. These inequalities negatively affect their rights. Like sexism, racism is a system that we have inherited and that we're not always aware of. It is by understanding its mechanisms that we can hope to put an end to it. And to do so, we must go back. Since the 16th century, the big colonial empires have used pseudoscientific theories about human races and the so-called civilizing mission of the white man to justify the colonization of the other continents. Canada was also built on colonialism and racism. In 1876, the Canadian government adopted the Indian Act, which designates Indigenous people as non-citizens. This law is still in effect today. In Canada, until the beginning of the 19th century, thousands of Indigenous and Black people were enslaved. Until the 1950s, schools in Quebec taught that there were four human races and that the white race was the most evolved. From the end of the 19th century until the end of the 20th century, more than 150,000 children were forcibly placed in Indigenous residential schools in Canada to kill the Indian within them. Therefore, racism is a foundational part of our history. Today, it continues to exist in laws, in public policies, in the economy, in language, in culture, and it causes multiple inequalities. For example, in Montreal, racialized people are 4 to 5 times more likely to be stopped by the police than are white people. Indigenous people represent 23% of inmates in federal prisons, while they only represent 4% of the Canadian population. For decades, in Canada, thousands of Indigenous women and girls have been murdered or have disappeared. In Montreal, people with Quebec-sounding names are 60% more likely to be invited for a job interview than those with African, Asian, Arab, or Latin American names. Neighborhoods with the highest proportion of racialized people are the poorest, and those which have the least access to services, to shops, and to public transport. Racialized people have more difficulty finding housing. Racialized people occupy only 3% of senior management positions and of corporate boards. They are largely excluded from cultural productions, media, television, and theater. And when they are present, it's often in a stereotypical way. All these inequalities mutually support each other and are part of a larger system. That's what systemic racism is. You, me, are part of this system. Individually and collectively, we can all do something to change it. We can recognize that systemic racism is a problem, listen to people who are subjected to it, and let their experience be heard. Be open to critique. Become aware of our privileges and prejudices to better deconstruct them. Denounce racist discourse and behaviors. Question the ways of doing things that exclude or discriminate against racialized people. Support the struggles of anti-racist groups. Push for public policies that promote equality for all. Check out the tools produced by the Ligue des Droits et Libertés and share this video.